And today we are going to be installing some DeeZee truck bed rails on my GMC. So here's just kind of a quick rundown of everything that comes in the kit. And this is part number 99701. I got it in the textured black, but I believe it also comes in silver and glossy black finish. So these are part of the hex series from DeeZee. So in essence, everything runs on this hexagon pattern, and then it uses channels to do for the mounting of the hardware and then for any accessories. So these will complement my hex series running boards pretty well. So starting at the front, you got the front stanchions and then the mounting bracket. So in essence, this bolt will drop through the stanchion and it goes into that plate, and that's what holds it into the front stake pocket. Then you got the mounting bolts, which these bolts will slide into the channel. So just like all hex series, so it slides into the channel there, and that's how you tighten down the rails themselves to the stanchions. Then you got a plate that everything sits up on top of, so everything's nice and cleaned up. So that's the front. Then on the rears, you have, again, the rear stanchion, same thing. So they're interchangeable. The rear plates, the bolts are mounting the actual rail to the stanchions. And then it mounts slightly different in the rear in that you use this bracket. So this drops into the stake hole, but this drops down into that hole. Then you use these two speed nuts, bolt through the top, which goes through the top of the stanchion into the top of here with the speed nut. And then you use this bolt that cuts through the side of the bed into this speed nut. Now there's a couple preparation things you need to do before you get started with any of this stuff. And the first thing is, let's go. On the front, basically what you need to do is cut this out. Now I used a rotozip a couple months back when I had the hooks, the tie down hooks in here. But this stuff cuts like butter. In order to prep the rear for mounting the bracket in there, you have inside your truck bed, there are rubber plugs here. Now I have a bed liner sprayed in here, so they sprayed over the rubber plug. But basically what I did is I drilled out this hole. Now if you don't have a bed liner in here, you could just pop out the rubber plug, and that's where this bolt slides through into a speed nut into the bottom of this bracket. So when this bracket slips in, it sits right down in there, and then a bolt goes through your bed and holds it down nice and tight. So let's get started with the install. Oh, last thing. Just like with the running boards, the caps have to be put on once you get the rails, because I'm pretty sure that these rails are just a general size, and then they cut them down to length for your short bed, long bed, medium bed. Real quick note, as far as tools, it's pretty simple. Whatever you need to do to get the rubber plugs out, so in my case I just drilled a hole big enough to fit that screw, but obviously you either need a knife or some kind of screw to pop out those rubber plugs, and then up front you're going to need a knife or a rotozip or something like that to cut open the top of your truck bed rail. But as far as tools for mounting the hardware, they give you a hex head, so this is a 3/16 Allen wrench. I don't like using those, so I have a ratchet version of it, so we're going to go ahead and use that. Then you're also going to need a 13 millimeter wrench, which will tighten down the mounting hardware for the stanchion to the rail itself. All right, so we're going to mount the passenger side front stanchion first. And like I was saying earlier, it's pretty simple. So you got that long bolt. It cuts through the bottom of the stanchion. There's a hole there. Seats pretty nicely in there. It goes through the plate and then goes into this mounting bracket here. And essentially what happens when you tighten it up, you're going to pull that mounting bracket all the way up to the bracket, and it's going to pinch underneath on the bed rails. So you got a few different options as to how you want this. You could have it sit cockeyed in there so it holds both sides. What I'm going to do is push it as far forward in here as I could, which will still allow this plate to cover the hole. But what it'll do is it'll pinch the front of it underneath the front, because there's a lot of room in the front of the stake hole pocket. Seats right like that. Then you just go ahead and tighten this bad boy down. So everything should stay pretty loose. It should just at least hold it in there for now. It'll, when you're first starting to mount it, you should loosely put it in there. That way you got some wiggle room with it, but enough to hold it in place. So then we're going to do the back, and then the reason you leave this is because you're going to essentially slide that front rail all the way on. All right, so the last thing we do before we slide on the rail is we're going to take these bolts with the square nut, and we're going to thread that nut light loosely on there, and that's what's going to hold the rail down. So we'll do that on the front over here. And then the last thing we'll do is the plastic caps on these things don't come installed, so you got to install those. Basically you just push them in and then knock them on.
But you just want to make sure that the plastic opening lines up with the channel on the top and the bottom. And then from there, we're going to go ahead and slide everything up. On there, but I now understand why they give you the Allen wrench, because it's kind of a special Allen wrench, and I'll show you in a second. But if you look at the Allen wrench, it's shorter on one side, and that's so you could get underneath here and tighten down this bolt. So the first thing we're going to do is tighten down this so everything's cinched up, and then we'll go ahead and tighten these down as tight as we can get them, making sure that bracket lines up nicely. And then from there, that truck bed rail is done. So the one to watch out on this one is that the bracket on the rear. So basically the way this works is you install the top bolt through here, so it goes through the stanchion on the rear into the bracket, and then it kind of swings when you're putting it into the rear stake hole pocket, which makes it kind of a pain in the butt with this because the screw is about a half inch too small. If this is just a little bit bigger, it would have been fine. But what I ended up having to do is take a thin piece of metal, and when I was putting this in, push the piece of metal from the outside of the truck in, which pushed this up against the inside of the bed liner, and then from there I was able to thread this bolt right in there. But again, I had to slip that piece of metal in there to make sure that this was able to connect with threads and get it tightened. And once you get started, obviously it's pretty easy, but a little pain in the butt. So let's go ahead and we're going to tighten down these guys first, which will hold the bracket straight, and then we'll come back and tighten the stanchion mounts to the truck, and then this bed rail is done. So as far as lining it up, I'm just going to line up my rail with my tunnel cover, and I believe it should line up front rear. Yep, it lines up exactly with the front rear on my roll up tunnel cover liner, and then we're done. And we'll do the driver's side.
All right, well there we go. Both sides are on. Took a little bit longer than I thought because it took a little while to figure out how to get the inside the mounting bracket in here to push up against there. Again, the solution to that is longer hardware. Particularly the bolt that goes through the bed. That would have been much easier if it was a longer screw. But other than that, everything looks good. Tunnel cover closes nicely with it. The rails don't hang out too high. Let's see here. So about 3.5 inches over the top of the bed rail. So not too ridiculous. Enough to get your hand underneath there. But I also, I could still get it to my tunnel cover so I can pull that taut when I roll it up and roll it back out. But other than that, Hex Series truck bed rails, very happy with how they turned out. So with the channel up here, there's hooks you could get, or rings I guess, for tie downs. So if you're ever going to have anything in your bed that's larger and you want to tie down here and not just go to the rail itself, you could get rings that slide into these channels. The other thing I was thinking is this would be a pretty cool spot to mount rock lights, so you could put a light here that it could either shine into the bed or it could shine down the side of the car because you got enough room there. But basically it's just a simple square bolt that goes in here. You just tighten it down. It's just like a Unistrut system. So overall, very happy with how this turned out. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye.